Alright, what's going on, people? Hope everything's okay with you. In this tutorial, I got to working on my LFS. I put it down for maybe a couple days, something like that. And, after the reboot, I noticed I had no Ethernet, no nothing like that. But that's the least of our problems right now. I'm gonna show you how to fix that in the next tutorial. But right now, I would like to, focus on changing the font, because we can't really work with anything, we can't see anything. And a lot of OS's, they make the font so small, it's kind of impossible to see, okay? So, this is kind of similar to my other tutorials, but on fonts and changing fonts and stuff like that. But this is a little bit more complicated, since we have a bare bones. I mean, as you notice, we don't even have ifconfig. Okay, so we have a super slimmed down, bare bones version of an OS, and we're going to beef it up, and right now, the only thing that we can kind of do is improvise with some of the things that we got. So, let's go ahead. Now, I'm going to pull up screen. If you have no internet, alright, and most likely you don't, the default drivers for my internet, I didn't have them, and I had parts of them, but I didn't have the exact drivers that I need, so I can't get online through my LFS. And even if I could get online through my LFS, I don't have I think it's IW tools, it has IW config, and it's got WPA passphrase and all that stuff, WPA supplicant, DH client. We'll go get all them later in some of my BLFS tutorials I plan to make. Okay, but let's focus on font right now. So like I said, I don't have internet, and I'm going to download from online SCH root into my LFS. Okay, so I'm using Slackware 14 right now, and let's go shopping. So I'm going to choose a font and call it, I think it's Terminus. Terminus font. Terminus font is the font that I'm going to choose. And I'm going to say for Slackware 14. Okay? And I'm going to go to Slackware, Slack builds maybe. Let me check that out. See what that looks like. Okay. Now, I'm not really going to get the Slack build file. I'm going to go get the source, okay? Slack builds, even on Slackware, Slack builds just don't work for me. And I find myself it's easier just to go ahead and configure. So watch my URL at the bottom, okay? I made the font a little bit bigger so you guys maybe could see it a little easier. I don't really need to worry about dropping any packages or anything, so, or any kind of mishaps like that. So I'm going to go to packages, and let's see, I'm going to go to 12. And I want to get something like this No Arch 1 Alien TGZ, okay? The ASAC, that's a text file, you don't want that. Meta, it's going to be nothing. And list is just going to list out the files most likely, so just get that, okay? And you want to say save. But make sure where you're at, you're okay to save. So hey, Control A, Control C. And you see I'm here, okay? And you're not going to dump it somewhere where you shouldn't, you know. So I'm going to say save that, and I can say quit. Okay, so I found my font. I want to make a small directory here and call it out to LFS. Okay, and let's move my Terminus font, I'm going to move that to out to LFS. Alright, now I'm going to CD into out to LFS. And I want to make a directory. I'm not really going to, I just want to look at the contents of it before I actually go ahead and install it. So, make a directory, I'm going to call it temp. And CD into temp. And let me say something like tar xvf. Terminus font, and it'll extract it here. Okay. All right. So good. I have a few things. I have an install file and a user file. Okay, so let's cat install do install sh, and we'll pipe it through less. And this is if you want to run it as install file. I would say this would do it by itself, okay? And I don't want to do this. And the reason why is because there's a lot of things that we don't have. Even though Slackware and LFS are very similar, there's a lot of things that we don't have as far as customizations. Wow, I don't even have GPM on here anymore. Took my GPM off. But say, if you follow my cursor here, there's a lot of things we don't have, like Etsy X11 org. Of course, we don't have that. We have that, but it's going to be a little tight until we can actually put some packages on this thing. So I would not recommend really running this install file here, okay? So I'm going to exit that, and I want to list out user and see what's in it, okay? So I got user doc. I have share. Let's see, can I get a treat on it? I don't know. Maybe. Let me say find maybe. User. And I can just say less. Okay. So this is gonna kinda show you what's all in your the package here. Okay? It's just tons and tons and tons and tons of fonts. Okay, so that's what you got. So that's okay. Let me say something like, I'm gonna go back up here and I'm gonna bail. I'm gonna go straight over to my LFS machine now and I should be okay. I think so. I'm actually installing this for myself right now, and I've done like two or three installs on my test machine, so I got this. We got this. So let me say control A. I'm gonna say sudo su. I'm gonna chroot into my machine now. Okay. And you don't have to chroot into your machine. This is just for me because I'm trying to record a video and I don't have the right tools over on the other side to record the video. Okay. So I'm gonna say mount type ext3 dev sda 7. It's gonna be to mount sda 7. Okay, and I can then say something like chroot. This is not a literal chroot command. Okay, I could chroot a little bit better than this, but I'm not going to. Chroot mount SDA 7. I'm gonna say bin bash e login. Just bin bash. Present working directory, my root. Let's see. Okay, cd into sources. Okay, good deal. Okay, so like I said, I'm using screen, so don't get confused. I'm gonna go back up and I wanna keep my sources because I'm gonna have to extract my kernel again, okay, and add some drivers to that. And let me say, I want to make a new directory. I'm gonna call it new sources right here. Actually, I'm putting in root new sources. Okay, and this will just be a temporary directory, so I can I'll eventually kill all my other sources out there, but I don't want to do that right now. I'm gonna cd into new sources. Okay, and I'll control A again. I'm over on my LFS machine. And now I'm gonna copy this. I'm going to copy terminus font. I'm going to copy that to mount SDA 8, and we'll say new sources. SDA 8. Something. We'll do that. Permission denied. Okay. No problem. So let's say sudo su. And I want to copy verbose terminus font over to mount SDA 8 or 7. Ooh. SDA 7 new sources. Okay. Now I'm gonna flip back over to my LFS machine. You see I have the package here. Okay. Cool deal. So now I can say tar XVF terminus font. Let me get rid of that. I don't wanna actually make a it doesn't matter. Okay. Cool. So I have the package extracted now. I still have the old source here. You can actually save this source. It would be a good idea to save this tar.gz file. Okay, move it around. That way you're not pulling stuff. You don't have to keep track of anything. Okay, so you can do that. Now, I don't want to use the install file, but I can use the user file. Okay, so all I'm pretty much going to do is I'm going to copy for Boose. Let's say I'm gonna copy user all to user, okay? And there's trees underneath of that user directory back here, this user directory, okay? Let's list it out so you guys get a better affirmation on what's going on. So we can say user, and then that's another tree there. We can say share, okay? That's another tree. And fonts is going to be a tree. You know what I mean? So we're really not overwriting anything in our user file right now. Not in this file here, okay? So you can see this here. This is our user file. We're not overwriting anything. We're just going to be putting in packages, or actually putting in new directories. And whatever's in those old directories should still remain there, okay? So we're just going to copy stuff over. That's all we're going to do. Okay. So let me say copy RV user. Watch your forward ticks and back ticks. Okay. This is not the same. This is not the same as that. Okay. That means that it's here. The other one means that it's in root user. Okay. So I'm going to copy user all to user. Okay. Alright, good deal. So, how does that look for us? Let's go to, let me say, I'm going to simulate a small font now, okay? Simulate a small font. The only way we can see a big font is if we simulate a small font. So, that's what I'm going to do. So let me flip out of this, go over here. And I'm going to say chroot into, actually I had to be sudo for this, sudo su, and I'm going to chroot into my LFS partition, SDA7 with bin bash. Okay, good. So the packages should have been copied over to user now, okay? So we can go there. We can cd over to the user, okay? And I'm gonna flip back the other screen. We can cd over to user, but also remember that we have user, and there's also a doc and a share, okay? So we can cd into share. Okay, there's a lot of stuff in here. Okay, no biggie. And then we can say something like cd into share fonts. Okay, that's another thing. See, now on our LFS machine bare, we don't have that directory. We don't have a fonts directory. Okay, so this made a fonts directory as it went in. And we could have did something like maybe install. You could just say install that in the path name, and I don't see why that would have been a problem either. Okay, I just copied it over, so I can then say cd into fonts. Now I'm on my LFS machine, small font. Okay, and then we have a local directory. We can go there and list it out, and these are all fonts here. Okay, now I get problems when I try to run fonts from this directory here. So there's another directory which was not on our default LFS machine either. It's in, I think it's Where is it? There it is. User share. Look at my present working directory. User share. KBD. Okay? KBD. And console fonts. Console fonts. CD into console fonts. Fonts. Okay? And these are other fonts here. Now these ones seem to work for me better. And I'm sure there's a difference, and I'm sure I'm not just picking it up. You know what I mean? But it's there. Now, let's say, too, we can actually change the font right from here. I can say set font for Bose. I'm going to type in Terminus. Let me call it 130B. Actually, 130 doesn't exist. 132. 132B. And need that suffix right there, okay? So there you go. See that? Okay? So, obviously, I'm not going to have that font that big. That's nuts. Let's say, let's back it down to 120 again. That's a little smaller. That's something you're probably working with. I kid you not, you're probably working with something about a 12. Or maybe a 14, maybe? Yeah. Most likely you're working with something like a 14 right now. I mean, I don't know why a lot of machines do that when they boot up. By default, the console is super small. Super small, so really don't like that too much. And it's very, very important, I think, for us to even be able to work, just to change that so it would be more beneficial. And actually using that, that's terrible. That's a 124 font, something like that. Okay? So, now I'm here. I know I can change the font, okay? I know that we have a command, which is set font, okay? That's stock on our system. We can set font, and that's okay. But the problem is, I don't want to come here all the time to do that, okay? So, what I want to do is, I'm going to make a temporary script, okay, that I can run, and I'll be able to change the font on the fly. I'll show you how to do that. Okay, so let's make a directory. Make a directory, call it for Bose, and, root. We'll call it tempor, okay? Root tempor, okay? And let's echo out this stuff here, set font. Let's echo out our present working directory. Let's echo that out. Remember, if we wanted to do the output of the command, echo that out, encase it, and we'll encapsulate it and throw in some backticks. Echo that into root tempor, and I'm going to call this change font. Change font dot sh. Okay? And let's also echo out our command that we ran down here. Okay, and we can do that. We can do that. We're just going to echo this out. We're not going to do anything. We're just going to echo out this string. And we'll put that two greater thans. It means append to the file instead of overwrite the file. Okay, so we'll say into root tempor change file sh. Okay, now, so we're here. This is where your fonts are going to be, alright? So you can actually get a kind of a look at, you don't have to have the Terminus fonts if you don't want to. There's other fonts you can get, but I'm going to use Terminus. And even if you don't like my font or anything else like that, you can always change it up. So, but you can look at what's back here, okay, and you'll have to select them, alright? But we won't have to select everyone as we go. So let's cd into root, and we're going to go tempor, okay, and change font sh. Let's say vi change font sh, Okay, so we've got nothing here. We're gonna make a little script here so we can change it on the fly. Okay, we're gonna manipulate it, mess with it, something else like that. But this will definitely come in more. It'll come in handy. It'll come in. Oh man. It'll come in hand. There you go. It'll come in hand. And what I'm going to do soon. So we'll say, always kind of try to make it look okay. You never know. It might be a dev or something. Devs don't like seeing crap. So let's say, changes font. Changes font. On the fly. Okay. And let's say here, we're going to use this as our path. Okay? This is going to be our path to our console fonts. Alright? So, why don't we call this something like path to fonts? Path to fonts. Okay? We'll make this a variable. So, we'll say font. Font path, font underscore path. Watch your variables too. Don't make them something that would be something else. Okay, watch your variables. You know, I throw in a lot of underscores. Underscores are kind of regular and say C and all that other stuff like that. But when it comes to Bash, not so much. Okay. So we have a path set. It's going to be user share KBD fonts. Okay. Remember we picked KBD fonts because fonts didn't work in the other one. Okay, so we got KBD fonts. Let's throw a forward slash after this here so we don't get any errors on that type of botching. Okay, and that's the directory. Now down here is actually the font name that we're going to choose. Okay, so I'm going to copy this line with escape DD. Let me say, go down and say paste. Okay. And I'm going to cut that apart in a second. And I want to say something like default font. Okay? And my default font, actually, I'm going to cut that out now. I'm going to change this here to be my default font. Okay? So if I say of course I can't. Can I say paste now? No, I can't. I lost it. I'm going to say right here, make a little space, and I'm going to say default font. And let's say we're going to make this our default font. So I can say escape, move this up a little bit, move this down a little bit. That's going to be my default font. So I'm going to set the variable and call it def font. Alright, and that's going to equal, don't forget to encapsulate. Okay, don't forget to encapsulate. That's going to equal that. So now, really, if I wanted that to be my default font, which I do, but I don't, I'm going to make mine small, okay? You can make yours as big as you want. Make sure they stick to the according rules up there in the user share KBD console fonts. Make sure your font's there, okay? But that's the font I'm going to make mine. And let's get rid of this much here. Let's get rid of our variable here, or our actual font name here, because we're not in the directory. I'm going to write that. And let's shore this up a little bit. And now, all we can do is, we can say something like set font what font do I want it to be? Well, I want it to be the combination of font path and default font. So, if you throw a dollar sign outside of your, if you got two squigglies here and you throw a dollar sign between it, it's not too different from double quotes, okay? So I'm going to do that. And it works okay. Bash is a little complex, and we'll get into that one day, but this is going to be okay. I don't want to throw double quotes all around everything, because it's going to be not so much. So the first variable I want to say, I want to set font. Remember we had our pathway, so we need to set the pathway first. We'll say set font, font underscore path. Alright? And no spaces, to shove that right up close against it because we had to put another variable in there. And if we put a space there, well, there is no KBD console spot, console fonts space ter 128B. Okay? We don't really want to do that. The next variable we're going to throw in is going to be our default font. Okay? Alright. It looks a little bit better than a whole bunch of quotes everywhere, I think. Yeah. So, let's do that. Let's run that and see what happens. So, let's make it change mod it. And we want to make it executable, 755. Actually, I don't have to do that. It's already executable. And we're going to say change font sh, okay? Now, if we run change font sh, there we go. That's not too bad. Not too bad. I could probably spice it up maybe to a 4. I think I'll do that. Actually, can we say, I don't remember if 22 is there. I think we tried 22 and that was bad. So I could say change font again. No, there is no 22. I think 24. 24, I think. Clear. Eh, that's okay. Alright. Now I would like to change this too. I'm not too good with arrays and whatnot like that, but I would like to make this an array. Have a number set, and I can make this take arguments like I did in my other tutorial, and it would increment. Okay, so I say set font with an arg of 1, 2, 4. And it would, you know, get bigger as I said those arcs. But for right now, this is okay. Yeah, that's not too bad. 124. I'll probably change it. It doesn't matter. But that's what we can do here. Okay? And if you noticed, you see we get a string of stuff after we run that. Okay? We get a string of stuff after that. We can hide that and make it look a little bit more cleaner on the output, okay? And it's not a problem. So this is going to give us output. We can take that and we can say put into dev null, we'll say 2 and into 1, okay? Let's run that, see what we get now. Nothing. Great. Okay? And even if we change the font, I'm going to make it smaller again. Even if we change that now, we still shouldn't get any output at all. Did that change? It's a problem with my eyeballs. Into dev null 2 and 1. I'll tell you if it changed now, 28. Didn't change. Vi. Ugh. I don't know why Vi does that sometimes. You guys might notice that too. I don't know why that thing happens like that. Now can I save Vi again? Alright, now let's run that. Font's not changing. I think it's my dev null over here. Dev null 2. Or is it And I think I had them backwards. Yeah, I think I had them backwards. Pretty sure I did. Now let's run it. There we go. Okay. So there you go. Vi changeFont.se. So all that does is it pipes the output that you would get as a command executes. It just pipes the output to into and one. You know what I'm saying? It pipes it into def null. 2 and 1 is standard in and standard out, or standard error maybe. Pipes it into 2 and 1, so you don't see anything. And you can hide a lot of verbose activity with programs by doing that. Okay, if you get it right, like I didn't at first. So for the sake of the 2, I'm going to back it down to 24. Right quit, and then I can say run. Okay, cool. Good deal, good deal. So I'm going to cut the video here, but on the next one, I'm going to keep going. Every time that we have to change our font, this is not going to be permanent. We have to, when we change our font, we have to run this every time we change our font. As a matter of fact, we have to run this in every terminal when we go change our font. That's kind of annoying, okay? So with major distros, you have RC scripts and everything else like that. But with our distro, we do have RC scripts, but none of them have anything about set font or anything about the font in it. So in the next one, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to show you how to make an RC script so that this runs at boot all by itself. So, that was long. How many minutes was that? 31 minutes. Oh my god. I'll catch you in the next one.